3:30 in the afternoon. I should be doing my homework inside my own room, but bad luck got me all messed up. I'm in the locker room and now I'm stuck. Guess I'm a goner now. See, I was walking, Snot was talking. I remembered something. I'd forgotten to grab my wallet because I was rushing. Then he said, I'm finna go to my grandma's house. I shrugged and I turned around, back to the school, but then who did I found?
Nice.
Oh no, this is not who I wanna see. Was running till I saw an opening, and now the whole soccer team's bound to freak. She's approaching the locker. They're done practicing soccer. She's opening the locker. Wish there was somewhere to block her. So these girls pull me out of the locker, talking about what the hell you doing up in here. I'm like, hold up, you need to lower your voice. Do I make myself clear? She like, whoa, who you calling a b-? I'm like, you. She like, who? I'm like, you. Wait, hold up, let me explain all the shit I've been going through. Let's start over. My name's Steve. It's nice to meet you, ladies. Cut that bullcrap, Steve. We know that you've been acting shady. So listen close, cause this is what we are gonna do. When somebody's creeping, we calling Jewel. Not Jewel. Yes, Jewel. Oh no, Jewel looks like a grown-ass man. 14 years old, at least 250 pounds. She's coming at me. And this is when things start to get foolish. The roof caved in on top of her. Oh my God, it's Lewis. 3:47 in Principal Lewis's room. This fool is having a panic attack. I hope this is over soon. He was talking about budget cuts, no pest control for months. I wasn't perving or looking at butts. I was in the AC, man, hunting for rats, I swear to God. Man, that's your business, not my business. I don't need no update. I got a new woman, so we need to get our story straight. We, what the f*** you talking about, man? There's no we. Steve, if my new woman hear about this, man, she gon' leave. Wait, what the heck was that? Sounded like a rat. Then he pulled out a Jericho 9mm, started busting. And just when I thought it couldn't get more scary, when he opened the door, the rat turned out to be Secretary Mary. So I'm speeding down the street, reaching for my phone, about to have a fit. I'm calling the one dude who can help me out of this mess. Ring. Come on, Snot, I need you to pick up the damn phone right now. And the next part's so jacked up that it hurts. The dude that picked up wasn't Snot, it was Mars!
Hello?
I'm tripping, what the heck is going on? Maybe I called the wrong number and got the wrong phone, but the doors are open, smells like potpourri. I walk in and what do I see? Snot and Mertz playing Risk. I'm betrayed, my favorite game. You're playing with that bully. What, now y'all close? Wait, you're drinking milk and cookies. Snot was like, listen. No, 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 no. I can explain. Well then, go ahead and explain yourself. Then Mertz jumped up, said, I'll explain so that you two will cool it. See, his dad died and my dad died and Risk is therapeutic. I was like, amen. Snot was like, amen to that. I love Risk too. Damn, y'all bonded over Risk, that's beautiful. Principal Lewis kicked in the door, waving a 44, talking about don't speak, don't move no more. But Snot's mom came in and said, Lewis, baby, put down that gun and uncock it. And that's when we noticed they was wearing the very same locket, 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 locket. Now we all on the floor feeling clueless. Hard to believe it's Snot's mom was banging Lewis. Then Lewis says,
it's been a hell of a day. I'm glad this whole thing is out. Wait, why are you wearing a negligee? How'd you even know that you was fitting to see me? And whose clothes are those thrown over the TV?
And
Snot's mom was like, stuttering all over the place. And Lewis says, girl, unless you got Parkinson's, start talking straight. Baby, is everything okay?
Wait, hold up. I know this ain't the dude. That's the reason for the cabaret lingerie.
Then Lewis starts waving his gun around and busting shots off in the closet. Then Greg fell out, cried Avery, how could you be so dishonest?
Snot's mom screamed.
Now Greg's page is flashing blue. He says,
my babe's got a clue.
Next thing, his man is in the room. 7 minutes later, 12 adults with their guns out, talking about you f***ing her and I f***ed him while they all scream and shout.
But then Principal Lewis started laughing, just sitting there giggling to himself, just laughing. He said,
well, now that we've all made the connection, I hope everybody was using protection.
And they all started laughing because, of course, nobody had Snot's mom, Greg and Stelio, and this new couple, Gina and Chad. They was all just laughing, just giggling and laughing. And we snuck out while they was laughing.
Steve, I don't know why you're telling me this now, and I don't know